Good day everybody. In this video I'm going to explain how to estimate the stability of a slope. We're going to use a chart which is here on the right hand side. We have a few formulas that are necessary for our example. The slope we have here, it has a unit weight of 20 kilonewton per cubic meters, and it has effective cohesion. The soil has effective cohesion friction angle of 25 kPa and 20 degrees respectively. What we also need to know is the inclination of the slope face. In this case, it's given as 40 degrees. And in the first example, we're going to estimate the critical value of h, which can be the cut, so at which the slope is still stable. And in the second example, we're going to assume some h and estimate the safety factor. So let's start with the first example. In this case, if we need to find this critical value of h, we are going to use formula here on the top. So that will be the value of h that we need to find, and I can rewrite it as value of h critical. It will be equal to effective cohesion divided by unit weight of soil times m. So m is this value of a stability number. So the chart that I'm going to use, you can find in any textbook. So for this chart, we need to know slope angle. And in our case, it's given as 40. So it should be here, 40. And we also need to know the soil friction angle. In our example, it's 20. 20 would be here. So we see where we have a point here, so that's 40, which is a slope angle, 20 will give us cohesion. And the value that I'm going to get here, it looks like it's going to be 0.05. So now I'm going to put this number in the formula. So we know that effective cohesion is 25 kPa. We're going to divide it by the unit weight, which is 20, and multiply by 0.05. That's the value of m from the chart. And that should give us value of 25 meters. So that will be the critical value of h at which the slope is still stable. So pretty straightforward, we use the formula. Okay, so what we're going to do now, we will solve a different example. Let's say that we're going to have a cut with the h equal of 10 meters. So it can be any number, but I decided to choose 10 meters. And we would like to estimate safety factor. So what will be the safety factor of the slope when we have h of equal 10 meters? So to do that, we are going to use these formulas. And the procedure is not... It's a straightforward, but it takes a little bit of calculations. So what we're going to do first is we are going to find the value of this safety factors. So this safety factor related to the friction angle, and this safety factor related to the cohesion. And then the idea is that these safety factors must be equal. So let's start with the safety factor for friction angle. So I'm going to write it here that safety factor for friction angle, it's a tangent of friction angle that is given, so which is 20 degrees. And then this value, it's a friction angle that will be mobilized for the stability of the slope. And what we're going to do is we're going to start with the value of 20, so also 20 degrees. In this case, we're going to put so 20 degrees. So the assumption is that the maximum value of the friction angle will be mobilized, and that will give us value of 1. So now what we're going to do is for this value of angle of 20 degrees, we are going to find the value of m, and it's going to be the same value of m, which is equal to 0.05, because we have the same values, right? So we have the same slope angle. which is still 40 degrees. And the assumptions that we make that for slope stability, the angle of 20 degrees will be mobilized. So that will give us value of 0.05. Okay, so now we are gonna put this value in this formula. And but first we're going to find value of C. So the formula that we have here, it's C is equal M times unit weight and times of H. So I use this formula, right? So this is the formula that we're using to find this value of C cohesion, and I'm gonna put it C mobilized. So that's the value of cohesion that will be mobilized for stability of the slope. And the numbers that we're gonna put in this formula, it's a value of M, it's 0.05 that we get from the chart. We know that the unit weight is given as 20, and that value of H, we assume that it's going to be 10 meters. So because that's for this value, we're estimating the safety factor, and that will give us value of 10 kPa. And now we are going to use the formula for the safety factor related to the cohesion. So I'm going to write it here that it will be the value of effective cohesion 25 and divided by the cohesion that will be mobilized when we have a friction angle of 20. So it will be divided by 10 and that will give us value of 2.5. So now we're going to compare these two safety factors. So this safety factor for friction angle we have 1, and the safety factor for the cohesion we have 2.5. You see that they're not equal. So now we're going to use the same procedure, but instead of selecting the friction angle of 20 degrees, the one that we did here, so the angle was here, we are going to change the immobilized friction angle to 15 degrees. And then we're going to repeat this procedure and estimate the safety factor related to the cohesion and safety factor related to the friction angle and compare them again. So in the end, we would like to get the same safety factors related to the cohesion and friction angle. So it takes a little bit of work, and I already did this using Excel spreadsheets, and I will show you in the next slide how it worked. Okay, so this is the numbers that I use, and I'll explain how I use them. In the first example that I already showed you before, I use friction angle of 20. Then remember that safety factor related to the friction angle was 1. Then I using this chart on the right hand side, I got the value of M, which was 0.05. And then I estimated the cohesion that would be mobilized for the safety for the friction angle of 20, and that gave me safety factor to cohesion 2.5. And you see that 1 and 2.5 are not equal. So the second step was I put use friction angle as 15 and put it in the formula, and in that case, the safety factor for the friction angle when we have 15 was 1.36. So then I, using the chart, I got the number of 0.072. So again, we're going to use the value of slope angle is still 40 degrees. But in this case, we decrease the friction slope friction angle to 15. And then that gives us value of here. So my estimation was 0.072. So that's the number here, right? So then I use that value of 0.072 to find the mobilized cohesion value. And I use the mobilized cohesion value, again, the procedure I showed you before, to get safety factor related to the cohesion. So I did it also for different friction angles. I decreased it to 10 degrees and to 5 degrees, and I repeated the procedure. So why I did this one? So that I can now plot two safety factors. That's one for cohesion, and this one is, sorry, this one is for cohesion, and this one is for friction angle. So I use Excel again to plot the numbers. So that will be a safety factor related to the friction angle. This one is regarding the cohesion. And these are the numbers that I got from the table. So from here. So these are the numbers that I plotted. And the idea is that we would like to find what will be the point when the safety factors are equal. So what I did, I drew a line which is 45 degrees here. You see that 0.5, 0.5 will go to the center. And that will give me the value of safety factors. That will be actually the safety factor for that slope. So you see that in this case, the safety factor will be 1.6. So now, going back to our second problem. So when we have the height of the slope 10 meters, the safety factor for that height will be 1.6. So that's how you solve it. Well, that's it for today. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day. Bye.